Can you honestly tell me that you feel no remorse? Not for killing children? Not for cutting off their genitals? Don't you feel the urge to confess to your crimes? My God, are you a human?
Thank you. Step through the door, please. Please don't turn around.
of goat slime.
TV and no beer make Homer something something.
Go crazy?
Don't mind if I do!
your breath. And showtime. It's nice and clean in here. There's no damage. Well, here we go. Easy.
We got it. Here it comes. Thing of beauty.
Excellent. I don't know about the rest of you. I'm hungry.
Abdomen, not to mention a gunshot wound in the chest.
to scare him.
Doesn't he look scared?
Blister, a festering pustule of malignant ooze. Worming worm of vomit. Uncle, a blister, a festering pustule of malignant ooze.
Oh my goodness. My goodness. This is really amazing. Well, this is one of the most remarkable things I think I've ever seen. I've read about it, but never had a chance to see one myself. When you first look at it, it looks as though it was trying to be another human being. When we see this, it looks as though it might be an arm, and this looks as though it might be a hand. It looks as though we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits where there's actually a nail we can see on at least one of them. And then this looks as though it might be trying to be a leg, although we only see 4 toes. But again, we seem to have nails there. And we have 2 other things that might be legs, but it's or an arm, but they're not nearly as clear. This one looks as though it might have been trying to be a leg or maybe an arm. There's a nail on what may be a finger. And this may be a very small abnormal leg that's not attached right. I think from looking at this that this probably represents the attempt to make a face. And certainly we can see one structure here that looks as though it could be an eye. And the other eye structure I think is in behind here, although it's a little hard to be sure. Then there's this structure here. The way it's sort of ridged and folded and a bit darker, this was probably a scrotum, and maybe this tells it that this would have been a boy. I think when this was inside the child, it would have been wrapped around like this. And I think it got its nourishment from the child by these big blood vessels here. And this is where this connected to the child. And this, because there were these connections, this is the only reason this actually survived inside the child and grew this big. So this, to me, constitutes a parasitic sort of humanoid, but not full human form, that was only able to survive and get this big because it could connect to the blood vessels of the more normal twin. And that sort of by definition is what a fetus in fetu is, as opposed to a teratoma, which is a tumor.
sponge.
Want me to complete the stitching, Dr. Kelloyd?
I need something to cut with, Dr. Rushton.
What, the scissors now, Doctor?
Yes, scissors. Now.
Scissors. Dan!
Examined him?
Yeah. I made one or two notes. In my opinion, the death of the poor bastard was caused by massive hemorrhage due to a huge laceration of the jugular.
Do you have a hypothesis for the cause of this injury? Take a look at these edges. To me, it's quite obvious what caused it. There appear to be clear indications of one or more bites. Look carefully. Pass me the scalpel. I wouldn't be able to cut my way through tissue paper with that, let alone carry out an autopsy. Take better care of your instruments, James.
Yes, Doctor.
Thank you. Specimen's awake.
Anesthesia?
Let's keep the circulation going. 2 milligrams of Primidol.
So, have you seen the list?
Mm-hmm.
And? Anybody interesting on it?
What's happening?
Some guy from Berlin.
Oh, yeah, and a Henning.
Henning?
Mm-hmm.
Which?
Henning.
Fall out, Polly. Excellent grades.
Johnson.
Johnson.
Professor, those lymphatic artery. This is not right. You're supposed to look at the bowel duct. Not the hepatic artery.
So according to you, this is the hepatic artery. That is the bile duct.
Thank you.
Now, I know everyone here is familiar with standard techniques of skin grafting. But what we're going to do is a little out of the ordinary. I'll explain as we go along. We're removing full thickness thigh material from the patient's thighs as per normal graft acquisition procedure. However, before applying the grafts to the damaged areas of the patient's breasts, abdomen, and so on, we're going to treat them so that they become morphogenetically neutral. They will then be called neutral field grafts. Well, when the thigh skin tissue is treated, it will lose its specificity as both thigh tissue and skin tissue. For example, if it were grafted to a burned cheek, it wouldn't just be thigh skin with the color and texture of thigh skin. It would actually develop as facial tissue. In other words, neutral field tissue has the same ability to form any part of the human body that the tissue of a human embryo has. Let me add that there is always a possibility that carcinomas will form when neutral field grafts are used internally. In this case, we're using a radical plastic surgery technique to compensate for the lack of heavy medical hardware.
If you're treating a patient and you discover a minor anomaly, do you ignore it?
Oh, man.
No, doctor, no. You cut it out.
Some growths are benign.
Not inside these walls.
Thank you. What is it?
Just expected to find some internal organs. There's any question now. Bite marks, the paralysis, and now this.
Minutes, 31 seconds. Doing fine.
The timing must be off. New resistance as I repeat the operation. The formation of an inner wall I cannot penetrate. That must not cause shock to the brain.
scalpel. We must make the incision as low as possible, for it's the only skin preserve available to us. Now going to detach the thermic mask, starting with the forehead. The flesh is too flexible. Oh my God. Compress, quick. Compress. Too much pentothal. It's ruined. Operation is ruined.
Remember, breathe through your mouth. Metal plate. Gambling chip.
And
jacket. Government issue, Army.
Pile of bones, and that's it.
That's it? No organs, no tonsils, no soup.
Human soup.
Thank you.
got a 29-year-old male with a GSW to the chest and shoulder. Patient was unconscious at the scene with labored respiration and low BP. We're bagging him and the IV's wide open.
Single entry only?
Single entry.
Hello, everybody. We are going to need a staff chest x-ray here. We're going to cross-match for 6 units. Then we're going to need a central line. Let's move him first.
Move him on my count, people. All right, 1, 2, 3.
Excellent. Very good. Go. Thanks, fellas.
Placing electrodes. Got a second IV going.
Starting second IV. 2-set monitor coming on.
I'm getting vitals. Monitor lines show sinus tap.
I'm having trouble bagging him.
All right, let's find out why.
BP 80 over 40.
I got no breath sounds coming on the right side of the chest. He's probably got pneumonia. His chest is full of blood. Let's get the thoracotomy tray over here. Gloves.
He's O2 sat from the 70, doctor.
Swab.
Let's go.
Come on, scalpel.
Dr. Cahill? Dr. BP's down to 60, still falling. Doctor.